Hello everybody. Today we are going to see about Maxwell's major connectors. There is a part component of remote partial wrencher. As we discussed some overview about components of RPD in previous video, go check it. Yeah, let's go into the topic. First, we actually see what is meaning by a major connector. It is defined as a part of remote partial wrencher which connects the components of one side of the arch to the other side of the arch. There are various requirements involved in the major connector. First one is rigidity, next is vertical support, indirect retention, patient's comfort, self-cleansing. Considering in the rigidity point, it is mainly used to distribute occlusal forces. And also there are various design considerations involved in major connector, that is intentional relief. And the border always should be parallel to the ridge and also gingival margin. Border should be rounded because to avoid interference while and also food accumulation. Let's go into the maxillary major connector. That is an important question asked in the university exam. Let's have a look about it. Maxillary major connector is defined as fabrication of maxillary process using a major connector. There are various requirements involved in the maxillary major connector. The first one is beading. According to what is meant by beading, it is a round thick border involved in the marginal areas and also used to display soft tissue, prevents the entry of food particles. Next, in requirements are of groove. Groove main size should be maintained at 0.5 to 1 mm and also it should be always 6 mm near the marginal gingiva. There are various types involved in this. First one is single posterior palatal bar, second palatal strap, single broad palatal major connector, double palatal bar, horseshoe shape connector, closed horseshoe shape, and next final one is complete palate. Let's have a look on single one by one here. First one is single posterior palatal bar. It also will run across the palate, and also it is a narrow one of oval cross section. At cross section point of view, it looks like a of oval, and also thick at the center point. The extent is marked always using a pencil, and also various patterns are involved here. Special casting wax or pattern waxes are involved here. Adapting wax can also be used here. Indications are they are used in interim partial denture, and also various complications disadvantages are there, such as poor bony support, poor vertical support, and also it can't be used in the anterior region because of interference of premolar tooth. So looks like the same major connector, but a single palatal bar and run across the palate is considered as a single posterior palatal bar. Next one is palatal strap. It is similar to the palatal bar, but here it is a most versatile one, and also it is a wide. The first one we see is narrow one. It is a palatal strap is wide one, and also thin band of metal plate is involved. Here 8 mm thickness is used. There 6 mm is used. Here considering to the point, there are three planes. The three planes are right, horizontal, right or left, and lateral strokes of palate. Indications are they are used in unilateral distal extension, bilateral short span, erentular spaces. And also considering to the point, coming to the point advantages. Retention, resistance, support, and patient comfort, and also indirect retention. Disadvantages are inflammatory tissue reactions. Larger areas should be, can be covered here. Palatal coverage, and also papillary hyperplasia. The next one is single broad palatal major connector. It is discovered by Thompson, and also it is contrapalatal coverage is involved here, broader than palatal strap. Here three forms are involved. Covers the area between the two or more three more erentular spaces. The next one is partial cast plate. The third one is anterior palatal connector. Indications are of class 1 cases, VR U-shaped palate cases, strong abutment cases. They are involved here. Advantages are of intimate contact, good vertical support, good retention, numerous surface corrugations. Disadvantage is same as a palatal strap, papillary hyperplasia. The fourth one is double palatal bar. Double palatal bar is also known as, it is a combination of anterior and posterior. That is a combination of anterior palatal strap and posterior palatal bar. Anterior part is always narrower than the conventional. Palatal margins are involved. They are lies on the valley, not on the crest of the ridge. Coming to the posterior bar, it is at cross section, it looks like a half oval, same as a palatal bar. The strap and the bar are two longitudinal elements. It lies along the lateral strokes of palate. Here three planes are involved there, and also mainly involved in the rigidity processes. Indications are of anterior posterior abutment tooth are widely separated, so it can be used here. Large incooperable palatal toric cases, and also to avoid complete palatal coverage. Advantages are rigid, strong, limited soft tissue coverage. Disadvantages are limited. There will be only some limited support from palate, and also patient discomfort is mainly concern here. The next one is U-shape, that is also known as horseshoe-shaped connector. It is also a thin metal band. Here, lingual surface of posterior tooth is involved. 6 to 8 mm of area is covered in the palatal tissue. Smooth, gently rounded surface will be involved there. Coming to the indication, they are involved in replacing anterior teeth and toric cases, excessive vertical overlap. These three cases are involved in the horseshoe-shaped connector. As it indicates horseshoe-shaped pattern, it is named as a horseshoe-shaped connector. Advantages are strong indirect retention and also involved in support. Disadvantages can't be used for distal extension denture basis. Increased thickness may also cause patient discomfort. The next one is closed horseshoe shape. Same as of horseshoe shape. Here, anterior-posterior palatal strap is involved. U-shaped major connector will be involved here. Strap of metal extends between the two onsets of horseshoe shape. Border will be 6 mm. Smooth rounded margins. Posterior strap is thin plate. Indications are of torus and also class 1 and class 2 cases. Advantages are of rigid strength support. Disadvantages, phenetic interference, patient discomfort. The final one, complete palate. It also covers the entire palate. It is a major connector. And also, it has anterior border. Anterior border is always as a 6 mm away from the margin or extends up to the single of the anterior tooth. Border seal is obtained. Beading is also used to prevent the food accumulation. There are various construction mechanisms here. The first one is acrylic, second metal acrylic, third is cast metal. Coming to the point of indication, it is used in posterior tooth replacement, class 1 cases, well-developed muscles of mastication, flat ridge and shallow walls. Advantages are best rigidity and support, and also best perception. Disadvantages, inflammatory reactions, hyperplasia, phenetic interference. There are design procedure of maxillary major connector. There are only 5 steps. First one is stress bearing area. Second is non-stress bearing area. Third was comparatively of major connectors. Fourth is choosing the connectors. Fifth one is functions such as comfort, rigidity, location, amount of inclination. These are the points considered to the design procedure. Thank you for watching. Keep supporting me.